start the new chapter, redox reaction. As all of you know that oxidation and reduction. So in redox reaction, both oxidation and reduction reactions takes place simultaneously. What is the oxidation? Oxidation, general term, as you studied before, that addition of oxygen is oxidation and removal of hydrogen is called the oxidation. Reduction, addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen is called the reduction. But now you will study the electronic concept of this oxidation and reduction reactions. What is oxidation? Oxidation is the gain of loss of electron is called the oxidation. Means the process in which loss of electron takes place, that process are known as oxidation reactions. What is reduction? Reduction means gain of electron. Means the process in which gain of electron takes place is known as reduction reaction. In any chemical reaction, in any ionic reaction, any chemical reaction, both oxidation and reduction takes place, in which one substance is reduced, at the same time other substance is oxidized. So redox reaction is the combination of both oxidation reaction and reduction reactions. So with some examples I am going to explain this reactions. Reducing agent, what are the reducing agent? The substance which loses electrons or which undergo the oxidation process is called the reducing agent. Oxidizing agent, the substance which gain the electrons are known as oxidizing agent. Like here with example zinc plus 2HCl, it will change into zinc chloride and hydrogen. If we see the ionic concept of it, in this you can see that zinc metal react with hydrogen ion of HCl and it will change into zinc ion Zn plus 2 and hydrogen molecule is formed. In this reaction the two halves are present, one is oxidation half and one is reduction half. Zinc metal change into zinc plus 2 ion with the loss of 2 electron. So loss of electron is known as oxidation. Loss of electron, oxidation. So this step where the oxidation takes place is known as oxidation half. One thing in elemental state, of any atom, the oxidation number is zero. The number which we are writing here is known as oxidation number. So in elemental state, like here, zinc is in atomic form, element form, here the oxidation state of zinc is zero. It will change from zero to plus two. Means oxidation state increases. So the process is called the oxidation. This reaction is oxidation half. The oxidation state of the element increases with the loss of electron. Hydrogen ion, which comes from the HCl, by gaining electron change into hydrogen molecule. So here gain of electron takes place. So this process is known as, or second half is known as, reduction half. Zinc metal change into the zinc ion. Means process is oxidation, but this zinc is known as reducing agent. Reducing agent. As substance which loses electron is known as reducing agent. Here the process is reduction, but hydrogen is known as oxidizing agent. The substance which gain electron is known as oxidizing agent. Second example, zinc plus copper sulfate change into zinc sulfate plus copper. Here zinc ion react with copper ion of the copper sulfate, Cu plus 2 change into zinc plus 2 and copper. So zinc change into zinc plus 2 means this process is the redox oxidation. Oxidation state increases and zinc metal change into zinc ion by loss of electron, so it is oxidation. Here copper ion change into copper metal. Copper ion by gain of 2 electron change into the copper metal. So copper ion by gain of the 2 electron in terms of reduction half and oxidation half means if we have to split this reaction into 2 half, reduction half and oxidation half, it will represent like this. Reduction half copper ion change by gain of 2 electron change into copper metal. Metallic state oxidation state is 0. Zinc metal oxidation state is 0. Change into zinc ion, so it is called the oxidation half plus 2 electron. And if we add both this reaction, we get the complete reaction like it. Zinc plus copper ion change into zinc copper ion plus zinc metal. So copper metal plus zinc ion. So this is the representation of the any reaction in its 2 half, or we can split any reaction into 2 half, and then by adding the reaction we can bring it a full reaction with the loss or gain of electron. Now the question is, we have to split this equation into 2 halves. 10 SN plus 2 when react with Fe plus 3 change into SN plus 4 plus 2 Fe plus 2. Here 10 oxidation state changes from SN plus 2 to SN plus 4 means loss of electron. SN plus 2 change into SN plus 4 means we can say that the reaction takes place, loss of electron, oxidation state increases, so this process is known as oxidation. Here iron plus 3 change into iron plus 2 means by gain of electron. So by gain of electron it means reduction. So this is the where SN plus 2 change into SN plus 4 is known as oxidation half, and this is Fe plus 3 gain electron and change into Fe plus 2, it is called the reduction half reaction. And whenever we have to represent the reduction half or oxidation half, every time we have to write the number of electron same both the side, as here 2 electron 2 electron, that's why they have to, we have to cancel it when we write the final reaction here. That's why here 2 ion of ferric ion, 2 ferric ion is taken, and here 2 ferrous ion is formed during the process to balance the reaction by the transfer of electron. Means SN plus 2 minus 2 electron change into SN plus 4, Fe 2 Fe plus 3 plus 2, sorry, 2 Fe plus 3 plus 2 electron change into 2 Fe plus 2. So final reaction when we add it, they will, both 2 electron will cancel to each other and we get the same reaction. Now this reaction, now in this reaction 2 copper, 2 Cu plus 2 plus 4 I minus change into 2 Cu I plus I2. Explain which ion is oxidized and which ion is reduced here. Here you can see that Cu plus 2 change into 2 Cu means copper plus 2 change into copper plus 1. So copper plus 2 by gain of 1 electron change into copper plus 1. So the reduction oxidation state decreases means reduction takes place. 4I minus change into 2 Cu(I) plus I2. Here iodine ion change into iodine ion here means in this process no change in oxidation state. So iodine, iodine being the same as I minus, but here when iodine change into the iodine molecule, at that time the reaction takes place by loss of electron, means oxidation state here change into zero. So oxidation state increases because it changed from minus 1 to 0. It means oxidation state increases, or we can say that it takes place by loss of electron. Loss of electron is called the oxidation. So this is the oxidation half, means iodine is oxidized here and copper is reduced here. This is your question, that explain which ion is oxidized. Copper ion is oxidized when it changes into the copper plus ion, and iodine ion is reduced when it will change into copper ion is reduced when it will change into copper plus ion, and iodine ion is oxidized when it changes into the iodine molecule. So this is for this reaction. Now some more examples. Children, you have studied just now all the reactions where transfer of electron takes place. Means all the reactions are ionic reaction. But in case of covalent compounds, it is difficult to show the transfer of electron. So there we can't show the oxidation and reduction phenomena by the transfer of electron. At that situation, a new term introduced, that is known as oxidation number. What is oxidation number? Oxidation number is the formal charge that present on the ion, that present on the atom. So in the oxidation number, we can explain by when in any molecule, when we explain the oxidation number, we have to follow certain rules. As first is, oxidation number of all elements in the elementary form or uncombined state is zero. As when if we represent the any atom in the molecular form like hydrogen H2, there the oxidation number of hydrogen is zero. If we write the helium, oxidation number is zero, because in atomic form or elementary form the oxidation number is zero. If we write only the in S8 is the sulfur molecule, N2 is the nitrogen molecule, here the oxidation number of sulfur and nitrogen is zero because these are the elementary form of sulfur and nitrogen. Second rule is, oxidation number of an element in monoatomic ion is equal to the charge present on that ion. As if we represent the sodium ion always we write Na+. So plus one charge that is present on the sodium ion is the oxidation number of sodium. To represent the ferric ion, Fe+3. So here +3 charge is present here on the ferric iron. So that's why +3 is the oxidation number of ferric ion. But for in the case of ferrous ion, we represent it by Fe+2. So it is the oxidation number of the ferrous ion. Fe+2 is the oxidation number of ferrous ion. Similarly, if we explain the any negative ion like chloride ion, Cl-, minus one charge is present here, that's why this is the oxidation number of chloride ion. If we represent the sulfide ion as -2, so -2 is the formal charge which is present in this monoatomic ion, that's why it is the oxidation number of sulfur ion. Sulfur in an S-2 state. Now, third point, oxidation number of fluorine in all the compound is -1, because fluorine is, all of you know, most electronegative element. That's why oxidation number of fluorine in all the compound is -1. Oxidation number of alkaline metal is +1, and alkaline earth metal is +2. Alkaline metals means sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, all these metal which are present in the first group, lithium, sodium, potassium, all these metals are known as alkaline metals, and in that case the oxidation number is +1 always. And alkaline earth metal means the metal which is present in the second group, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, all these, the oxidation number is always +2. Next point is oxidation number of hydrogen in all the compounds except hydride is +1. In case of hydride, as sodium hydride NaH, potassium hydride KH, there the oxidation number is -1. Calcium hydride CaH2, there oxidation number of hydrogen is -1, because plus represent +1 is the oxidation number of potassium, +2 is the oxidation number of calcium. Next point is oxidation number of oxygen is -2 except in case of peroxide, where the oxidation number of oxygen is -1. Example, hydrogen peroxide H2O2, sodium peroxide Na2O2, barium peroxide BaO2. In case of superoxide, the oxidation number of oxygen is -1/2, KO2. In OF2, oxidation number of oxygen is +2, and in O2F2, oxidation number of oxygen is +1. Because here fluorine is more electronegative than oxygen, that's why oxidation number has changed here. Total algebraic sum of oxidation number of all the atoms in any molecule is as, if we represent any molecule like hydrogen sulfate, sulfuric acid H2SO4, then the total oxidation number of the molecule is 0, and then we write on the calculate the oxidation number of other element. So one by one, now I am going to, with some example, I am going to explain this oxidation number. Now here are some examples in which you have to find out the oxidation state of some underlying elements. But before that, one example I am telling you for the water molecule. Here we know that oxidation is number of hydrogen is +1 generally, and oxidation number of oxygen is -2 generally. So, and for the new, we have to write down the oxidation number of both hydrogen and oxygen and calculate what is the oxidation number of the molecule H2O. So let us find the sum of oxidation number is equal to 2 into +1 plus -2, because of only one oxygen atom, that's a -2. So +2 -2 is equal to 0. Here 2 hydrogen atom, that's why we multiplied here +1 oxidation state by 2, but here only one oxygen atom, that's why I'm writing here simply -2. Now, second example, here sulfuric acid is given to you. You have to find out the oxidation number of sulfur atom. We know that oxidation number of hydrogen is +1 and oxidation number of oxygen is -2. So by putting this value, 2 into +1 plus oxidation number of sulfur, let us take as X. X plus 4 atom of oxygen. So 4 minus plus 2 plus x, 4 into 2 minus 8 is equal to 0. With the sign we are adding the numbers. Plus 2 minus 8 is equal to minus 6, x minus 6 is equal to 0, so x is equal to plus 6, means oxidation state of sulfur is here plus 6. Now third example, sulfate ion. Sulfate ion, here the ion is having the formal charge minus 2. Oxidation number of oxygen is minus 2, so x plus, x is the oxidation number of the sulfur, x plus 4 into minus 2 is equal to minus 2, this formal charge minus 2. Now x plus minus 8 is equal to minus 2, x, we bring this value minus 8 here, so it will change its sign. X is equal to minus 2 plus 8 is equal to plus 6. Now oxidation number of sulfur is plus 6. Now next example is K4FeCN6. CN whole 6. Potassium ion has the oxidation number plus 1. As it is the alkali metal, first group element, so plus 1. Rn we have to find out S. Plus cyanide ion. Cyanide ion has the oxidation number minus 1. So we are writing here minus 1. Here 6 cyanide ion is present. That's why we multiply it here by 6. 4 into plus 1 is 4 plus x. 6 minus 1 minus 6 is equal to 0. X minus 2 minus 6 plus 4 minus 2. X minus 2 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 2. Means oxidation state of iron is here plus 2. Now next is CO, cobalt hexaamine ion. So CO NH3 whole 6 plus 3 ion. We have to find out the oxidation state of cobalt here. Let us assume that oxidation state of cobalt is X. So X plus 6 into ammonia ion, ammonia NH3 molecule is having the oxidation state 0. So 6 into 0, or formal charge of this whole ion is plus 3, that's why it's equal to plus 3. X plus 6 into 0, 0 plus 3 means X is equal to plus 3, means oxidation state of cobalt is plus 3. Now, Na2S4O6, sodium is the alkali metal, so oxidation state is plus 1. 2 into 2 atom of sodium, 2 into plus 1 plus 4 atom of sulfur, 4x plus 6 atom of oxygen, oxidation state generally minus 2 is equal to 0, because neutral whole molecule oxidation number is 0. So here we are adding 0. 2 into plus 1 plus 2 plus 4x plus 6 into minus 2 minus 12 is equal to 0. Minus 12 plus 2 is equal to minus 10. 4x minus 10 is equal to 0. 4x is equal to, when we bring this minus 10, this side sign will change. Then x is equal to 10 by 4, it will become x, the value of x is equal to 5 by 2 plus 5 by 2. So the oxidation state of sulfur here is plus 5 by 2. Now you have to do more example that is given in your book, and then we have to do some more example. Here the oxidation state we get in fraction. Some more example we will see in the next video, in which you find out the oxidation state of some more atoms in fraction. So for today, thank you. Have a nice day.